Let's walk through the steps needed to take a tissue sample, because a lot of folks maybe don't know how to do that. So we're going to walk into the field here, find a spot that we want to take a sample. Now, how do you select the places to sample? Well, ideally you want to sample the poor area of the field, the bad area, but also if there's a good area of the field. We want to try to get that contrast, to get that comparison purposes. Tissue testing works best when we have a comparison for the diagnosis. So we want to go into the good area and the bad area. We want to take samples that are representative of the area. So what that means is we don't want to just take all of the samples in one little spot. We want to take samples from throughout the area that's either poor or good. And so one of the things you'll need is a bag to put samples in, and I've already pre-labeled these good and bad. So we'll just take one of these bags and we'll get it ready. And so how we're going to take this sample is, first, it's important to get the right growth stage. For alfalfa, we want to sample at bud to first flower, and the crop right now is kind of right in that growth stage, so it's perfect. The nice thing about alfalfa is you could sample it at any time during the growing season when it's at this growth stage, so you have multiple times to catch the sampling. When you do the sample, you want to look at your plant. And I don't have a ruler with me. I'm going to just judge that my hand is about 6 inches long, and I'm going to take a sample. And so that was just one. And what I need to do is I need to collect 35 tops like this. And ideally we want it from 35 different plants. We don't want it from the stems coming out of the same plant. So that gets back at being a representative sample of the area. You want to avoid plants that have insect damage or that are dead. It's not useful to sample a dead plant. You want to avoid sampling plants that have chemical or mechanical damage. And you also want to avoid sampling plants that are drought affected or flood affected. And the reason for that is there can be a lot of other things going on with the biochemistry in the plant that would change some of the tissue results that make it not very helpful for us to help with diagnosing what the problem is in the field. Now let's talk about sample handling here. One thing that you'll need to do is make sure your bag is labeled properly so that we know what field it is and is it coming from the good area or the bad area of the field. You always want to put your plant sample in a paper bag, not plastic. If you put your plant sample in a plastic bag and it gets a little warm after a while, you're going to end up with a pile of mush that we can't really analyze at the lab. So it needs to be a paper bag. If you are going to ship the samples overnight, you can probably just get them in the paper bag like this and get them boxed up and overnight them to the lab and they'll be fine. If it's going to be a couple days before you get them to the lab, what you may want to do is put them, lay them out to dry a little bit, get them in the sun, get a little fan blowing on them, dry them up a little bit, and then put them in. What we want to do is avoid the potential for the plant to start rotting before it gets to the lab. That's just not good for anything. So keep in mind, paper, not plastic, get it to the lab as soon as you can. It's always best, whatever lab you're using for these tissue samples, it's always best to contact them in advance to make sure you're going to be getting the samples to them in time and how they might want them handled, because maybe they might have a little bit different directions on how to handle the sample. So it's always best to contact the lab you're going to be working with. Now, the plant sampling is only the half of it, and that's kind of the easy half. You can run around with scissors and take these little clippings. The next part, to really be able to diagnose that there's a problem with using a tissue sample, is to get a companion soil sample. So what we also have here, in addition to my plant sample bags, I have some soil sample bags. And so we want a soil sample both in the good and the bad area of the field. The reason for this is tissue testing is not an exact science. You sometimes get results that don't quite make sense. Having a soil sample as well as a really good history of the field, what's been going on in the field, is often helpful to diagnose what's going on. It might seem like overkill if you think it's just a sulfur deficiency, but what happens if the tissue test comes back and says sulfur's not a problem? Then you need to try and figure out what might be. So all you need to do to take a soil sample, it's just like any other soil sample. You get your probe, you put it into the ground, 6 inches is what you want to do. Pop it out and put that into your bucket. Now, you don't want to just take one core. Like any good soil sample, you want to probably take at least 10 cores to represent the good area and 10 cores to represent the bad area. What you'll do then is get your sample mixed up, make sure it's a good composite sample because you have a bunch of cores, and then mix up in your bucket and then pour it into your sampling bag. Now, a note on how to handle the sample as well is if you're shipping the soil sample with the plant sample, we don't want the moisture from the soil to get onto the plant. So while you might sample into a paper bag like I have, you might want to, for shipping purposes, package that up into like a Ziploc bag so that it you keep the moisture contained within the soil. Another point on the tissue sampling that I forgot to mention, and this is very important, it's not as big of a problem in an alfalfa field like this because the tissue is way above the ground surface, but if you get to a place where you're sampling and it's a little bit closer to the ground, you might get a lot of soil that has splashed onto the plant, or there might be just a lot of dust. And what you need to do is take a brush and brush off the plant. You want to get the soil off of it because otherwise you get false readings on that tissue test. You do not, and I repeat, do not want to wash that plant with water. That can leach nutrients out and cause problems with the results. So just brush off the plant before you really package it up and send it off to the lab. And you know, at the UW lab, when we're analyzing a plant sample, the cost is, I believe, $25, and that includes a soil sample with it. So we're encouraging you to take the companion soil sample with the plant to help better diagnose your field.